All right, do we have anybody new today? Any hands? Lift your hand if you want free coffee or if you want. Anybody new? Okay, somebody over here. What's your name?
Natasha.
Natasha? Hi, Natasha. And then what's your name? Alex. Hi, Alex. Anybody else? Anybody else? I didn't see a hand. Maybe? Okay. Where? What's your name?
Diana.
Hi, Diana. Okay, cool. Anybody else? Okay. All right, so I'll get started. I should have brought some water up here or something, but that's okay. All right, so I'm going to talk about offering. And before I get started, I wanted to just like share it on more of a personal level. I think it was like meant for me to share specifically at this time in my life, because if somebody were to literally ask me to speak about offering 3 to 4 weeks ago, I don't know if I would say yes, and if I would say yes, I'd probably be the biggest hypocrite up here. Literally, like, in this season of my life, God has changed my view about offering. I was more closed-minded about it, you know, so I just wanted to share that. So more personal, so maybe more of you guys can understand. For me before, this is what my mindset was when it came to offering. You know, like people would speak about offering, and I'd be like, well, I'm not gonna offer with money. I'll just offer my time, and I'll offer in this, and this, and this, and this, but I won't offer in money. Like, and then sometimes I'll give $1, or sometimes I'll give $5 because I feel bad, you know, and people are looking, maybe I should just give $1, you know? And that was me literally, like, pretty much all my life, I guess, you know, like, until like 3-4 weeks ago. You know, that was my heart. I was like, well, I offer my time. I don't need to give money, you know? And another aspect, I was like, oh, well, God understands that, for example, when I had my first job, I was like, God understands I work a minimum wage job. He understands that I don't have to give like that, you know, like I was so selfish, but anyways, I'm still sometimes selfish, but anyways, and then I got a better job. God blessed me with a better job, better pay, just better job overall. And my excuse changed, but I still had an excuse. Oh, God understands. I have to pay for my phone bill now by myself. I have to pay for college. I have to pay for gas, and I go to school in Portland. Blah, 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 blah. Excuses can go on and on and on. And a lot of times we have that, like, should I, oh, wait. You know, God understands. I don't know. That was my mindset. Like, even though in the back of my head I knew, like, I can give, but I just don't want to, you know? And just like a few weeks ago, like there were some leaders really shared a lot about it, and it really opened my eyes. I was like, you know, I'm selfish, but anyways. So a lot of times, and a lot of times, what we do is that we just serve, and we sacrifice for God in all these different areas, but then we stop when it comes to financial. You know, we just want to give once in a while, and we just stop there. And why do we stop there, you know? Like, a lot of times when we're like, oh, I want to give more, God, like, I want to give more to you, you know, when we have, like, this revival in our hearts. I don't know, for me personally, like, I have this revival, and I have, oh, I want to serve more. Oh, I want to go reach out to people more. But then when it comes to money, I don't even think about it, you know? I'm thinking about all these other ways I can sacrifice and serve, but I don't think about money. And so why is it? Why is it that, like, it's so hard for us? Like, this is, like, I feel like one of the hardest areas for us to sacrifice. And it's because it's the hardest place to stretch us. That's, like, one of the hardest places to stretch. You know, you work, and then you're like, oh, now I gotta give it, you know? A lot of times it's the hardest place. And I personally learned that recently. And a lot of times for us, it can even be, like, feel like a burden more than an opportunity, which is a problem too, you know, and it's been corrupted. Offering in a way has been corrupted in our minds, just like a lot of things in the world, where it becomes like a burden, and it was corrupted where it's like, it's not a burden, it's an opportunity to give to our kingdom, but it's like a burden, and it's like, I don't want to do this, and it's like, it was corrupted by selfishness, you know, and for some reason, you know, it's so easy for us to go buy a Starbucks drink or whatever you guys like to drink, I don't know, for $5, spend $5, so easy. But then when it comes to give $5 to the kingdom, it's so hard, you know? And like, if any of you guys are struggling with that, you're in some hot water, because I was there, and that's some hot water, not like, you know, like bad water, you know? And so I challenge you guys, you know, just to give today. And like, you can have, you know, you have a choice today. Offering can be just a continuous routine for you, where you know after worship somebody's gonna come and talk about offering, and then the basket's gonna go around, and then you're gonna decide, should I give a dollar, should I, you know, okay, maybe next time, oh, I forgot my cash, oh, I forgot it again, you know, like all this stuff. You can have that typical routine, or you can make a choice to take this as an opportunity to serve kingdom, to serve God's kingdom. Because think about, personally for you, how much has the church done for you in your life? Like, where would you be without the church, you know? It's so easy for us to give to other, to, you know, spend money on other things, but the thing that has impacted us the most, for some reason it's so hard, and for some reason we have such a, it's such a burden, you know? But, you know, you can take, you can change that, you can change your focus on that, you can change your mindset. And then what else I was gonna say is, so, and if another person, like, I don't know, for me, like I said, giving a dollar or something like that, you know, for some reason we give a dollar and we're like, okay, cool, I feel good, you know, like, I give a dollar, I gave, like, nobody knows how much I gave anyways. But that, did that stretch you? Did giving that dollar really stretch you? Did giving that $5 or how much dollars that you feel comfortable giving really stretch you? And I challenge you guys not to just give because, oh, now, you know, you, every time you hear like an offering that's really good or something, you're like, okay, I'll give a little bit. But I challenge you to stretch yourself to the point where you're getting out of your comfort zone, where it truly is a sacrifice, where you're not just comfortable giving. Oh yeah, I just won't buy Starbucks tomorrow. Here's $5. No, like, give to the point where it's, you really are stretching yourself, you know? And why? Why does it matter if we stretch ourselves in this or not? Because money tends to be our biggest attachment to us, you know? Like, we try not to be attached to things of the world, we, you know, and like, obviously we need money to live and stuff like that, but when you're attached to it, that's a different story, you know? And a lot of times, this is like a test for us. How attached are we to our money? You know, are we idolizing it, or are we gonna like really use this, you know, for God's kingdom and to help, you know? And offering is not only something that stretches us so we do not attach ourselves to money. Offering also helps us truly lean on the Holy Spirit. I'm sure you guys maybe heard of Francis Chan. I love him. I read his, like, I like read 3 books of his at the same time, and I never finished any of them because I'm like, you should read this book. It's so awesome. And I'm like, didn't even get, Dennis is like borrowing one of my books right now too, because I'm like, Dennis, yeah. Because I'm always like reading it, and then I'm like, oh, so good. Listen, I'm reading this book. Here it is. And then I never get to finish it myself. But anyways, he's awesome, and it's bad. I should probably finish. But he says in one of his quotes in Crazy Love, which is one of his most like popular book, but he says, but God doesn't call us to be comfortable. He calls us to trust him so completely that we are unafraid to put ourselves in situations where we will be in trouble if he doesn't come through. And like, that is so intense, because it's like, you're literally depending on the Holy Spirit. It's not comfortable. We're to the point where you're, you know, you have to depend on the Spirit. And for example, for people when they're struggling, like they have financial issues, maybe you don't have a job, maybe, you know, you're in an internship, I don't know, or you gotta pay your bills and you're like, I'm struggling with money. This is a time for you to truly test and depend on the Spirit. Give and depend on the Spirit. And like, for example, people who are comfortable with money, you know, for you it may be different. Maybe you're like, for example, you think of an amount right now, what's an amount that would make me feel uncomfortable? Not comfortable giving, but like, really uncomfortable, and it's like, oh man, what if I don't have enough to do this and this, or get this and this for this week if I give that much because it makes me comfortable? Depend on the Spirit. This is just a time for you to truly learn and depend on the Spirit. And how many testimonies in our lives have we heard about people offering and depending on the Spirit, and how God always comes through? God, you know, he's always there. So so I challenge you guys to just sacrifice, and sacrificing isn't always easy, but it's always worth it. So, let's pray. Hallelujah. Father God, we just pray, Lord God, that we can just give to you more, Lord God. you see our hearts, Lord God, that we just want to continue to grow in you, Lord God. Continue to just strive, Lord God, to be closer to you. And I pray, Lord God, against this attack that sometimes people have of this attachment to their money, Lord God. We just proclaim against that right now in Jesus' name, Lord God, that people are willing to just give to your kingdom, Lord God. Give to what is most important, Lord God. And I just pray, Lord God, to help people to take that step, to jump out of their comfort zone, Lord God, and take that step of faith, Lord God. And I thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity, Lord God, that we have to give to your kingdom. In Jesus' name, pray, amen. Oh, and now Dima Tkachenko is going to speak.
What's up, guys? I have a quick testimony I'd like to share. So yesterday, I was driving home from church. I'm an intern. I live right here, but I went to my house where I live. And so I'm driving down the street, and all of a sudden my car starts to make this weird noise, like my wheel. And I'm driving, like I didn't think much of it, and my wheel flies off. My wheel flies off. I'm with a buddy, like an old buddy of mine, and we slide like 20 feet into like some grass place. There's like a bunch of grass everywhere. So we start looking for the wheel. I can't find the wheel, but we find the little bolts, all the little bolts, but we can't find the wheel. And so I have this feeling, the Holy Spirit tells me, pray for the next woman you see. And I was like, I can't. I gotta find my wheel. And so I'm like still looking for my wheel and I can't find it. And it's been like 20 minutes, can't find the wheel. So I'm like, I call my friend Elijah, intern two, and he said he's coming. So he's coming. And I still have this like thought, pray for the next woman you see. I was like, whatever. So I see this woman walking her dog. And I'm like, whatever, I'll go do it. My friend's like looking for the wheel. I'm like, bro, I'll be right back. And he's like, bro, what are you doing? And so I walk up to this woman. And I'm like, she's walking her dog. And I'm like, can I pray for you? And she's like, yeah, of course. And so I start praying for her. And she grabs my arm. She grabs my arm. And she closes her eyes and starts smiling. And tears start coming down her eyes. And I'm praying, and she's like grabbing my arm. Like, it started to hurt. And she opens her eyes, and I'm done praying. And I start talking to her, and I asked her something, and she's just like, thank you. She doesn't reply. She's just like, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. God, she says something. She's like, God truly loves me, and that made me, I was happy for her. And I started talking to her, but she like ran away with her dog somewhere. And I ended up finding the wheel after that. It just made me think, it's crazy how God can use people anywhere, anytime, anything to just help one person out. And after that, I had this feeling. I was like, you did a good thing. You helped this woman a lot. And so all glory to God. Praise God.
You know it's God when you find all the bolts, but you can't find the wheel. Man. That's awesome. You know, I had some, we get to the word, well, we're going to get in the word right now, but before we get to our main sermon, something that we did last week, or we want to do every week, is we want to give just 5-10 minutes where we're going to be talking about vision, talking about life groups, and talking about reaching out to people. And we kind of want to talk about this every week, pray about this every week, and then we're going to get to the word. So tonight, after I share, we're going to pray. And then we have our beloved senior pastor of this church going to be preaching tonight. Pastor Sergei is here. He has been to many of us a father. and a great example of a man of God, and we're privileged to have him here. You know, I had some things prepared that I wanted to share, working on it at home, and as we were in worship, got some specific things that God put on my heart to share right now instead of my notes and put my notes away. I want to read a verse in Matthew chapter 16. When Jesus is asking his disciples, "Who do you think I am?" In verse 17, he says this: "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for this was not revealed to you by man, but by my Father in heaven. And I tell you that you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it." Jesus says, words in red, "On this rock I will build my church." The church is not an institution established by men. The church is not even a corporation or some kind of company made by some guys. It's not a cult that came together because of a bunch of crazies in the first century. Jesus says, words in red, to his disciples, "I will build my church." Not man, not a group of people. Jesus, "I will build my church. And my church will be built on a rock, and even the gates of hell, Hades, devils, the demon himself, Satan himself, all of hell will not prevail against it." It gets even crazier. In 1 Corinthians, Paul gives us an illustration of the church. He says in chapter 12, verse 12, "The body is a unit. Though it is made up of many parts, and though all its parts are many, they form one body." And here's where it gets crazy. "So it is with Christ. For we were all baptized by one Spirit into one body, whether Jews or Greeks, slave or free, and we were all given the one Spirit to drink." So wait. Jesus says, "I will build my church on the rock," and Paul gives us an illustration that the church is us that make up his body. Do you know if we did not gather in this building would not be called a church? This church is called a church, and God's presence is here, not because somebody put Church of Truth on the front of the building, but because God reached out to some people and he saved them and he brought them together and he called it his church. But it started with a man, our senior pastor, who received a word from God, Luke 4:18 through 19, that "I have been anointed to preach the gospel, to bring good news to the poor, to release the captives from captivity, to heal the sick, to give sight to the blind, to give hearing to the deaf." And God gave him a word, and then God began to give him people, and these people began to come together, and now the vision that pastor received is being accomplished by the church, not by one man. See, what we mistake is when we think we're part of a church, we think, "Yeah, my church is, Andreessen off 500, and that's the building, that's where I go, yeah, I'm part of that church." But in any, do we show that we are a part of the church in our life? Do we show that at work? Do we show that by being connected to the church? You know, last week we talked about abiding in Christ and the importance of abiding in Christ. You know, when you see somebody that's begins to disconnect from believers, we've seen this in our church. I've seen this even in my life group, where people begin to disconnect from believers, and then they begin to disconnect from the church. You know what I realized, and God's been showing me a lot, is that when we see these things happening, what actually is the problem is that they disconnected from the head. He disconnected, or she disconnected from the head, and therefore, all of a sudden, church is not interesting to me. It's just a building. It's rules and religions and a bunch of people who are after something, but it doesn't make any sense to me. And why do I need to be in a life group? Why do I need to be meeting with people on Fridays to do Bible stuff and pray? What? No, what happened is there was a disconnection from the head. And all of a sudden, there's a disconnection from the body. And there's really no meaning of being in the body. Why? Well, because you disconnected from the head. When we realize that Jesus said, I will build my church on the rock. And Paul illustrates to us that Jesus building his church is the head of his church. And when we, like Pastor Sergey, received a word, received a vision for this church, received a vision for this city, and God began to bring people in, God began to save people, God began to heal people, God began to do things, and all of a sudden a church began to form, and these people are not just a membership of some company or corporation or whatever. No, they're a part of the body of Jesus, and they're connected to the body of Jesus. They're connected to the head of Jesus. Come on, I don't know any part of my body that's not connected to my head. The reason I move and function and can do what I do when I run, when I work, is because every part of my body is connected to the head. I receive signal from the head, and therefore I can walk like a normal person. I receive signal from the head, and therefore I can speak like a normal person. Every single part of the body of Christ is connected to the head. And when you lose that disconnection, you begin to lose connection with the body. Come on, why we want our goal by January 1st, 2016 is that every single member of G4T is plugged into a life group. We want you to get connected. We want you to be connected with people. We want you to be connected to the head. We want to help you be more connected. We want to help you see yourself in the church. See where you're at. The following passages after what Paul just said, he says, hey, can the eye say to the ear, I don't need you? Is the ear more important than the hand? Can the hand say, I'm not a part of the body? No, every single part is important. You just have to find your place in the body. Amen. Okay, man, let's pray. We're going to pray for just vision that our church has here about reaching out to people, about being in the body, for that to be a part of our life. We're going to pray for life groups, that every single person gets plugged into a life group. Every single person is connected to the head. And number three, we're going to pray about salvations. We want to see people get saved. We want to see more people come to this church, not just to join this church and come to some building, but be a part of the body of Christ. Can we just begin to pray all together as the worship team comes on stage? Come on, God, we thank you so much. We thank you so much. You said, I will build my church. I will build my church upon the rock, and the gates of hell will not prevail. God, we thank you so much that we are not just a building. God, we are not just some corporation, God, but we are your body. We are connected to you, and we thank you, God, so much for what you have called us to do, what you have called us, God, to do in this place. We pray for one another, God. We pray for each person here to be connected to you, God, to know you, God, to hear from you, God, to be an active member in the body, to be an active member in the church, in the name of Jesus.
Can I quickly share? I would like to quickly share a word before I pray about vision. As I was praying, I was asking God, show me what vision is. I felt like I didn't have a true perception of it. And so I was thinking, first I'd like to just quickly bring up a story, a little illustration. There's a story about a skater named Danny Way. And he wanted to be the first man in the world to jump over the Great Wall of China on his skateboard while building a ramp. So basically, to make a long story short, they set up the ramp, and he goes on the ramp at the highest speed that anybody's ever gone off a ramp to clear this Great Wall of China. He goes, as he lands on the other side, he falls. He tears his ACL and breaks his ankle. Nobody knows he did that. Nobody knows he did that anyway. He's like, hey, I am determined to jump over the Great Wall of China. And so he gets onto the other side, gets back, and gets on his skateboard and goes and clears the ramp with a torn ACL and a broken ankle. This is a true story. You can look it up for yourself. Nobody knew he had that, but after they did the examinations with the doctor, they found out he actually had a torn ACL and a broken ankle. The point being is, this man had a vision to clear the Great Wall of China. Though this is just a worldly example, my point is, we as people cannot be broken down and stopped by what happens by what the devil throws at us when our vision is to reach the lost, when our vision is to reach the people that aren't saved. If we're driving to somebody's house to pray for them and we get in a car crash, the devil is trying to stop you. Go to that person and pray for them. Be in the vision. Go after them. If you're driving in the day and let's say something happens and you get angry, but you were determined for that day to be a day for the Lord, still continue to allow that day to be for the Lord. Pray for somebody. Reach out. You never know what could happen. You just never know what God has planned. And I just want to say that we have to be determined to hit the target. Kind of like, for example, another example, when you're playing basketball and you want to score the ball, you do anything you can to score the ball. So let's do anything we can to save the lost. Let's do anything we can to help the ones in need, because we're blessed to be here. We're blessed to be in this church. There's people in China that are being persecuted simply for following their Lord. They're being killed. They're being beat. And we can be here. We can have the privilege of being here and not being touched to serve the Lord, to worship Him. This is a check not just for you. This is a check for myself. So let's live a selfless life for God, and let's pray for this vision. Let's pray to be determined to reach our goal to save the lost, to not just have everybody in here be free and be saved, but to really reach the lost, to really seek to save people through us. That's why we're here. That's our mission. Let's just begin to pray in tongues right now. Shira balala soto korobo, himanana sata kala balala soto korobo, shita sata kala balala soto korobo, himanana soto korobo. Lord, we need your strength. We need this, your strength for this mission to seek and save the lost, Jesus. We want to be your vessels, and we ask you for your strength. We ask you for your kingdom to come down through us, God. And I make myself willing, and I pray that we would be willing to give ourselves as a sacrifice toward your glory, God. And I just pray that your love would always just flow out of me like a river, Jesus. And I pray that you would ignite my soul, ignite our souls in a vision to seek you, in a vision to save the lost, yes, in a vision to pray for somebody when we don't feel like it, to pray for somebody when the devil is trying to tell us that there's going to be nothing good that comes out of it, God. But I just pray that we would be determined to listen to your voice, to listen to the Spirit that speaks to us, that we would not ignore the very Spirit that is there for us and within us, that you came and you died for, Jesus. And I just pray that we would be in sync with this vision to save the lost, to bring up the people that are broken, to bring up the people that need freedom from sin, freedom for whatever it may be, freedom for lust. And we speak against lust in the name of Jesus. We speak against lust. The great wall that has been risen up by the devil, we speak against that in the name of Jesus. It stands no place in the church of Jesus. It stands no place, Jesus. And we just declare freedom, and we declare that we would give ourselves to you, and that nothing would stand in the way, that we would just have that sacrifice be there for you, whether that's reading the Bible, whether that's giving our time, whether that's giving our finances, Lord. I pray that we would not hold ourselves back from your kingdom, Jesus.
Yes, church, let's just pray in the Spirit right now. Come on, church, let's just stand for these life groups right now. Yes, Jesus. Yes, Jesus. Oh, Rabba Baba, yes, Christ. And we just stand for these life groups, Jesus, that you've just planted, Father, in our church, in this body, God. Father, that you've just put in our lives, oh God, to just reach out to those souls, God, that are just hungry for you, God, that are just broken, that are just lost, Father, that just need healing from you most of all, Jesus. Father, we are just so grateful that you have just applied such great leaders in this church, Father, so that they can just lead, Father, in our church and guide, Father. And just set a foundation for this youth, God, to just follow you, God. We just pray, Father, for your love and for your fire to never just burn out in us, God. Father, for these life groups, Lord, and the helpers and everyone that's inside a life group, God. May their vision, Lord God, for you never die out, Father, but just grow constantly. We just pray for the prayers on Friday nights, Lord God, for more to come, God. For more to come to you, Father. More to come to your feet, God. Lord Jesus, we just pray, God. Shite rababa, shite kelere. Yes, Lord. Yes, God. Shite rebelere.
Yes, Father, we thank you, Lord. We pray for salvation, Jesus, that people would begin to encounter your love, God. That people would not know religion, that they would know you, God. That they would encounter your love. They would encounter the person of Jesus Christ. That I pray, God, that you set us free from religion, God, and mindsets that are not from you, God. I pray that you set us free from the lies of the enemy and strongholds, Jesus, that we would know you, that we would know your love, Father. Pray, God, that you would just begin to break down walls, Jesus, in our hearts and pour out your fire on our hearts, Jesus, and give us your heart for the lost, God. Help us see people how you see them, Jesus. When we're at work, our circle of influence, God, we pray, God, that you just help us to have your heart, God, and to just be so sensitive to you and so close to you that we would just speak your words of life to these people, God. And we pray that you would have all the glory in our lives, Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. Can we all lift our hands right now as a sign of thanksgiving to our Lord? Just begin to thank him right now that he chose you, he put you, he connected you. Just begin to thank God right now that you are chosen, that you are chosen. Hallelujah. Father God, we thank you. We thank you, Jesus, that you chose us. And today we can bear fruit for your kingdom. Father God, I bless every person in this room. Every person. Every person. Father God, I pray for every person in this room that they will bear fruit for your glory and for your kingdom. We worship you, Jesus. And everybody said, and everybody said, amen. Amen. Come on, let's give God glory. God is good. God is good. God is good. Come on, shake your neighbor and say, be awake. Be ready to receive a word. Awesome, awesome. Can we have everybody seated? Hide your phone. I encourage you to take notes on a device that will not disturb you, that you would always be connected to the message. Amen. Amen. Well, tonight it's a privilege for us to have our senior pastor with us, and I believe it's going to be awesome. Amen. So I'll challenge you to hear every word, accept every word, and live it every word. Amen. Amen. Come on, let's welcome Pastor Sergey.
Добрый вечер.
Good evening.
Я рад находиться вместе с вами.
I'm happy to be with you guys.
Я знаю, что время особенное сейчас здесь.
I know that we have a special time here.
Потому что мы в самом лучшем месте находимся.
Because we're in the best place.
Знаете, люди ищут разные места.
You know, people look for different places.
Один человек зашел в мебельный магазин.
One person came into a furniture store.
И он долго-долго ходил.
For a long time he walked around the aisles.
Садился в разные кресла.
Sat down in different chairs.
В разные диваны.
Into different couches.
И подошел к нему работник магазина.
And an employee came up to him.
И говорит: "Может быть, вам помочь?"
Can I help you?
Он говорит: "Мне нужен диван."
He said, "I need a couch."
Чтобы я мог сидеть в нем.
So that I could sit in it.
На протяжении 5-6 часов.
5-6 hours.
И не уставал.
And not get tired.
Он говорит, что я постараюсь вам найти такой.
He said, "I'll try to find you a couch like that."
И он садился и сидел и ожидал.
Walked around, sitting and expecting how comfortably will he feel.
Вы знаете, люди ищут.
You know, people look
разные вещи, чтобы чувствовать себя комфортно.
For different things to experience comfort.
Но вы знаете, может быть хороший город.
But you know, there might be a good city.
Цветущие пальмы.
Beautiful palm trees.
Красивые рекламы.
Beautiful advertisements.
Возможно, этот город возле побережья.
Maybe this city is on the coast of some kind of ocean.
Но если в этом городе.
But if in this city.
Нету здоровой хорошей церкви.
There is no healthy church.
То это не то хорошее место.
It is not the right place.
Может быть, город не совсем приглядный.
Maybe the city might not be so attractive.
Может быть, стоят трубы заводов.
It might have factory pipes sticking out.
Может быть, климат не совсем подходящий.
Maybe the climate isn't so perfect.
Но если там есть народ Божий.
But if there are the people of God.
Люди с горящими сердцами.
People with burning hearts.
Которые ищут Бога.
Who seek the Lord.
Это хорошее
this
место.
This is a good place.
Вы знаете, мы на этом месте.
We are in this place.
Это хорошее место.
And this is a good place.
Потому что Бог здесь.
Because God is here.
Кто-то сегодня сидит в баре.
Somebody's sitting in a bar tonight.
Кто-то, возможно, сегодня в каких-то темных местах.
Somebody might be in some other dark places.
Кто-то, может быть, просто встретил друзей.
Somebody might be just hanging out with their friends.
И они где-то, может быть, распивают.
And they're getting drunk somewhere.
Но вы сегодня сюда пришли.
But you've come tonight here.
Потому что вы неравнодушны.
Because you're not careless.
То, что происходит в этом мире.
What's happening in this world?
Вы неравнодушны.
You don't just stop caring about that. And God has something for you tonight.
Потому что Он на вас рассчитывает.
Because He's relying on you.
Вы не знаете через час или два с какой обстановкой вы встретитесь.
You don't know the circumstances you're going to be in an hour or two.
Вы не знаете с какой обстановкой завтра вы встретитесь.
You don't know what circumstances you'll be in tomorrow.
Когда вы придете в школу.
When you come to school.
College, на
when
работу,
you go to college, work.
С чем вы соприкоснетесь?
What you will encounter.
Но сегодня на этом месте Господь.
But tonight, in this place, God is here.
Что когда вы встретитесь
to ensure that when you meet those circumstances, for you to be ready. We are ready only in the case if we have a relationship with God. When God's in our life, we're always ready. Hallelujah. Tonight, I want to continue the thought that's already been spoken here about influence. We're called to influence. No matter who you are, you're called to influence.
Influence
deals with not with our talents. Not because I can speak so wonderfully. Not because my hairstyle is cool. Not because I can dress with fashion. But today, people think that they can attract people to themselves with that. But that's a lie.
Может быть, человек не очень.
The person might not appear so attractive.
Может быть, у него есть какие-то недостатки.
The person might have some physical flaws.
Сегодня мы живем в таком мире.
Today we live in a world
когда люди комплексуются.
Where people get shy.
Потому что им не нравятся какие у них брови.
Because they don't like the eyebrows they have.
Какие у них щеки.
They don't like the cheeks they have. What kind of eyes they have.
Им не нравится для них. Им не хватает одежды в магазине.
They lack the clothes that's available at the stores. To get the right clothes that nobody else has. So that somebody can pay attention to them. And people become shy or in a complexion.
Я хочу вам сказать.
I want to tell you.
Самое привлекательное место.
The most attractive place.
Куда всегда влечет.
Where everybody's always attracted.
Это там, где есть помазание Святого Духа.
Is there where there's the anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Если вы будете помазаны Духом Святым.
If you will be anointed with the Holy Spirit.
Вы будете самый красивый человек.
You will be the most wonderful person.
Самый лучший на земле.
You will be the best person on earth. You will be the most attractive person.
Потому что Дух Святой.
Because the Holy Spirit.
Это единственная личность.
It is the only identity.
Которая никогда не унизит тебя.
That never puts you down.
Не сделает тебя.
That never makes you shy or self-conscious. It is the only identity that will transform you. And you will not look like a model, not like some actor. Today people look up to these famous people.
Ты будешь похож на Иисуса.
You will look like Jesus.
Потому что Дух Святой преображает нас в Иисуса.
Transforms us into Jesus.
И это здорово.
And that is wonderful.
Не правда ли?
Isn't it so?
Поэтому мы поговорим сегодня о влиянии.
That's what we're going to talk about, influence today.
Мы призваны влиять.
We're called to influence.
Между тем,
amongst
когда
that,
мы начинаем что-то делать,
when we start doing something,
есть вещи, откуда мы стартуем.
There's always a place we start from.
Очень важно правильно стартовать.
It's so important to start the right way.
Очень правильно понимать,
it's
на чем
so important
я стою сегодня.
To understand what I'm standing on today.
Когда мы что-то делаем,
when we do something,
мы как верующие люди.
Like Christian people.
Мы не должны это делать за компанию.
We shouldn't do this just because the group is doing it.
Мы это не делаем потому что модно.
We shouldn't do it because it's fashionable.
Потому что так все делают.
We shouldn't do it because that's what everyone's doing.
Мы должны понимать.
We have to understand.
Почему я это делаю?
Why I'm doing this?
И это понимание.
And this understanding.
На чем я сегодня стою?
Of what I stand on today.
На чем я сегодня основываюсь?
What I'm relying on today.
В нашей жизни,
in our lives,
рожденных свыше людей,
people who are born from above,
прочное основание.
We have a firm foundation.
Это наша вера,
and that is our faith in Jesus Christ.
Она должна быть непоколебимой.
It must be unshakable.
Самая мощная.
It must be the strongest foundation.
Это независимо от того,
independent
что я могу чувствовать,
of what I might feel.
Я верю в моего Спасителя,
I believe in my Savior,
который простил мои
who
грехи,
has forgiven my sins,
омыл меня
who's
кровью
washed
своей,
me with his blood,
очистил
who's
меня,
cleansed me,
поставил ноги
who's
мои
set my feet
на твердое основание,
on a firm foundation,
в мое сердце,
in my heart,
наполнил радостью,
he's filled me with joy, he's given me a new song in my mouth, I will praise him.
Это он мой Господь.
It is he who is my Lord.
Даже будет
Even though it might be hard in my life, David says, even when war comes against me, it's not just a conflict with a person. War comes against me. When armies come against me, he says, I will not fear. I will not fear. Because the Lord is with me. I rely on Him. What are we standing on today? Who do we rely on today? We must recognize and determine very firmly. I stand on Jesus. He is my unconquerable foundation. I rely on Him. He is my Lord. This is our starting point. We must recognize this in our life.
Апостол Павел говорит, чтобы мы крепко утверждали.
Apostle Paul says for us to grow firm.
Не просто как получится, но
not
крепко.
Just that, oh, how it will work out, but grow firm in the inner man,
который рожденный от Бога.
Who is born from God.
Мы должны знать, кто
we
мы
must know who we are in Christ.
Вы знаете, влияние,
you know, influence,
это не из-за того, что я что-то смогу сделать.
Doesn't come because I'm capable of doing something.
Влияние это то, кто через меня.
Influence comes from who can do something through me. That's why I am confirmed in Jesus. He can do abundantly more. He is the one that I believe in. He is the one I rely on. He can do abundantly more. The one who is in me is greater than he who is in this world. Beloved, the word of God says that we are given authority. Jesus gave us his authority.
Вы будете иметь свою власть.
He didn't say that you will have your own authority.
Он сказал, что я вам даю мою власть.
I give you my authority.
Чтобы вы наступали.
For you to go and step on.
Он говорит, что мне дана власть.
He says that the authority is given to me.
На небе и на земле.
In heaven and on earth.
Он говорит, эту власть,
and he says, this authority that I've received,
я передаю
I pass on to you.
Кому он дал?
Who did he give this authority?
Людям, которые
to people
в него,
who have believed in
которые
him.
Встали
people
прочно
who
на этом
have
основании.
Set firmly on this foundation. They have this authority. This is the starting point for us. Because in this life, we will encounter different circumstances. But when we know who we believe in, what foundation we stand on, it doesn't matter what storm is coming against us, it doesn't matter what the quakes are going to be like, we will go through it. Because we have Jesus Christ in our life. Praise God. I want to emphasize, we live in this world of which the Bible says that it lays in evil. The Word of God says that it's controlled by evil.
Когда мы здесь собрались в этом помещении,
when we gather here in this building,
мы говорим о Господе.
We're talking about God.
Мы прославляем Его.
We're praising
имя,
His
мы
name. We sing songs to Him.
Мы провозглашаем
we proclaim
то, что написано в Слове
what's
Божьем,
written in the Word of God.
И правильно делаем.
And that's the right thing
и
we're doing.
И это действительно так.
And it's truly so.
Но за пределами этих стен.
But beyond the boundaries of these walls.
Весь этот мир,
this whole world.
Он находится во мраке.
It is covered by darkness.
И дьявол контролирует.
And the devil's controlling it.
И мы, когда выходим за
пределы этих стен, leave the boundaries of these walls,
вы знаете, что я заметил?
You know what I've noticed?
Это нередко, но часто бывает.
This happens quite often.
Вдруг мы,
all of a sudden,
становимся такими же,
we become the same,
какие люди на этих улицах,
as the people that are walking these streets beyond the church.
Даже мало кто знает, кто
and
мы.
Even very few people recognize who we are.
Мы приходим в школу.
We come to school.
Мы говорим те же самые
we
истории.
Say the same stories.
Можем участвовать в разных пошлых разговорах.
We can participate in dirty talks.
Говорить какие-то анекдоты.
Say dirty
быть
jokes.
На уровне со всеми.
Be on the same level as everyone else.
Кроме этого,
and besides
мы
that,
думаем, как бы не отличиться.
We think, man, I don't want to stand out.
Чтобы кто-то не подумал,
I hope nobody thinks
что мы какие-то другие.
That I'm different in some way.
Я хочу вам объявить.
I want to announce
до тех
to you,
пор,
until
пока мы будем искать,
while we are seeking
с этим миром,
compromise with this
чтобы
world,
подстроиться под него,
to somehow blend
in, на него,
to look like this world,
Бог никогда
God will never
не раскроется в нашей
open
жизни.
Up in our lives.
Никогда.
Never.
Мы должны объявить, кто
we must announce who we are.
Мы заявляем,
we must proclaim who we are, who we believe in.
Я помню, как один мальчик,
I remember a small boy.
Это было здесь, в Ванкувере.
This was here in Vancouver.
Этому мальчику было 14 лет.
This boy was 14 years old.
Он ходил в middle school.
He went to middle school. And he was put down. Because he said that he's a Christian. And so his peers, they put him down. Because he wasn't skipping with them. He wasn't smoking with them. He wasn't doing these negative things with them. And so they put him down. And they would tell him, hey, you're lacking in life. And he said it'd be alright if it was just the Americans, but there are so many of them, Russian speaking guys that went to school with him. And when they saw him, they tell him, hey, don't come up to us, you're humiliating us. But they all came to church and everything was okay. And every time he met with somebody, they tried to shove him, they tried to make a joke over him. And one day he came and he was crying. He said, I feel so lonely. For some reason I don't fit into that group, but I have to keep studying. And I asked him, why did they treat you that way? He said, because I don't do what they all do. I don't live the life that they live. I openly proclaim that this is sin. And they consider me old-fashioned. And I remember we prayed for him. We encouraged him. You know, time passed. Just a little bit of time. And a person came up to him in school. He said, listen, I know that you're not like the rest. I have a problem. I can't come up to these guys that I smoke with, that we steal beer together with, because they're just like me. I know they're not going to help me. But you have something. You stand out. I want to tell you my problem. And so he opened up. And he started telling him directly, I can't help you. But I know the one who can help you. I know the one I believe in. I know, and he started telling him about Jesus. And that difficult teen who opened up his life started repenting right there in the hall. Beloved, we must proclaim who we are. Independent of what humiliation we might walk under after. At one point God will exalt you. These people who are in the darkness, they will see the light that's in us, and they will seek this light. They will find you if this light will shine in your life. We must understand, we must act the right way. Our influence are not our good sounding words. Our influence is our relationship with God. Our influence is what we can pass on, is what we have in God. You know, in this world, in the world of evil, today all these open doors for the evil to fill this world. We are witnesses how homosexual marriages are being legalized. It's even difficult to pronounce that. That's called a marriage. That doesn't even exist. God created man and woman for marriage. That's why I don't even call that a marriage. It's just a union of a homosexual relationship that we've legalized. Because marriage is holy. Family is holy. God has determined it that way. And he created Adam and Eve for these relationships. But we see today openly how this disease is filling the earth. This isn't just a neighborhood somewhere in San Francisco. This isn't just some secluded place that was influenced by this. You know, but this year we were witnesses how on a federal level they've made this law. This country that's always been called a Christian country, where it was built on biblical principles. Today we see how this decay is happening.
Вы знаете, если в какой-то стране какие-то беззакония происходили,
injustices
то эта страна отстаивала ценности.
America always stood on the values, the moral values.
Вы знаете, легализованные аборты.
But today, abortion is legalized.
Это не просто легализация.
This isn't just legalization.
Убийство детей в чреве.
Of the murder of children in the womb.
Это сегодня среди несовершеннолетних.
But this is happening
сегодня
in teenagers.
Сегодня принимаются законы.
Today, laws are being passed.
Не обязательно говорить родителям.
That you don't have to tell your parents.
Что девушка беременна.
That the girl is pregnant.
Есть места, куда она может пойти.
There are places she can go to.
И там убить этого. Если она зачала и убить этого малыша.
And murder the child if she's pregnant.
И никто не узнает.
And nobody will even know.
Весь этот мир он лежит во
тьме. This whole world is covered by darkness.
Это сегодня происходит.
This is happening today.
Вы знаете, влияние этого мира
The influence
сегодня,
of this world today.
Это не просто на людей.
Isn't just influencing people
у
somewhere.
У дьявола есть своя стратегия.
The devil's got his own strategy.
Все, что происходит.
Everything that's happening.
То, что связано с разложением.
Everything that deals with the decay of the world.
Сегодня пропагандируется.
Today it's in the
разложение
propaganda.
Подростков.
And they're advertising the decay.
Чтобы вот эта моральная чистота упала.
So that the moral purity would fall.
Поэтому сегодня поощряются
That's why they encourage today.
Сексуальные отношения they encourage между несовершеннолетними
in teenagers before marriage.
Сегодня говорят, это нормально.
They say that that's normal.
Это не только здесь.
It's not just here.
Сегодня это во всех цивилизованных
It's
странах.
Being preached in all the civilized countries.
У дьявола есть стратегия.
The devil's got a strategy.
Ему все равно.
He doesn't care.
Сколько людей во тьме живут этим.
How many people are living in the darkness?
Ему не все равно.
What he does care about.
Есть люди в этом мире.
Is that there are people in this world that don't live the way this world lives.
Есть люди, которые знают намного больше, чем знают другие люди.
That know a lot more than the others.
Ему не все равно.
He cares about that.
Поэтому все, что происходит,
That's why everything that happens,
это чтобы завлечь нас туда.
It is to attract us
then, в эту тьму,
to pull us into the darkness,
делать нас серую массу,
to make us the gray mass, like everyone else.
Сегодня уже мы привыкли
Today,
к этому термину.
We are already used to
как все.
The terms like everyone else. That's how everyone else dresses. That's how everyone else talks. That's how everyone else walks. That's how
Потому что это
how,
все.
That's what's accepted. That's how everyone else does it.
Все.
Listen, we're not like everyone else. We're not going to the drumbeat of this world. We have a promise from God. We are a different people. We are redeemed by God. We are separated from this world for one goal, to influence this world. We are called.
Поэтому мы должны четко
That's
понимать
why we must clearly understand this
среди чего мы живем,
what we live amongst,
с чем мы соприкасаемся,
what we're encountering,
и что мы можем сделать.
And what we can do.
Знаете, кто-то опустил руки и говорит,
Somebody's let their hands fall and say,
сделать.
We can't do anything about it.
Уже, мы уже опоздали.
We're late.
Один пастор, мы с ним
разговаривали. One pastor who I had a conversation with, he asked me,
Sergey, Бог не дал тебе откровение.
Did God give you a revelation?
Какая будет следующая страна?
Of what the next country is going to be?
Потому что Америка она погрузилась во тьму.
Because America is falling into darkness.
Надо спасать людей.
We have to save people.
Надо куда-то выезжать.
We have to move somewhere.
Я слышал, кто-то едет в Южную Америку.
I heard somebody's going to South America.
Есть откровение.
There's a
куда-то в пустыню.
Revelation about some desert somewhere.
Я говорю, я имею откровение.
I said I have a revelation.
Он говорит, да ты что?
He said,
я
really?
Вижу, как в нем глаза загорелись.
I see him get excited.
Вот, серьезно?
Seriously?
Ты не шутишь? Я говорю,
You're
нет,
not joking. I said, no.
Я такими вещами не шучу.
I don't joke around with that. I'm very serious. I have a revelation.
Он говорит, куда нужно ехать?
He said, where shall we go?
Я говорю, есть одно место.
I said, there's one place.
Где дьявол достать не может.
Where the devil can't reach you. He said, no way.
Есть такое место.
Where is that?
И где это?
Where is it?
Это где-то в Южной Америке.
Is it in South America?
Я говорю, нет.
I said no.
Наверное, где-то в Саудовской Аравии.
It's probably in Saudi Arabia. I said no.
Может быть, это где-то место в Израиле.
Maybe it's somewhere in Israel. I said no.
Это место, где написано.
It says.
Где однажды сказал Давид.
Where David says
что Господь это крепкая башня.
That the Lord is my strong tower.
И в нем я укрываю.
And I cover in Him. And I am safe in Him.
Все, что нужно,
All we have to do
Господа,
is to find the Lord and be covered by Him.
Однажды Давид сказал, что Он сила моя.
That He is my strength.
И я не убоюсь зла.
I will not fear evil.
Слово,
the evil that's around
мы не будем бояться,
us, we shall not fear
если мы сокрыты в
if
Боге.
We're covered in God.
Я хочу вас вдохновить.
I want to encourage
you. Есть единственное место.
There's only one place.
Место, через что мы можем повлиять.
Through which we can influence.
Это пребывать в Боге.
It is to abide in God.
Это находиться в Нем.
It is to abide in Him.
Это вести чистый образ жизни.
It is to have a clean way of life.
Это быть чистым сосудом.
It is to be a pure vessel.
Это просто влюбиться во все.
It is to fall in love with everything that Jesus loves.
Иметь это в своей жизни.
To have that in my life.
Поступать так.
To act obediently as He acts.
Тогда.
Then
мы можем повлиять на
это. We can influence this world.
Мы влияем, мы имеем это.
We have this influence.
Мы имеем.
We have this.
У нас есть все, чтобы влиять.
We have everything we need to
Бог
influence.
Сделал все, чтобы мы влиять.
God's done everything He needs for us,
знаете,
to influence.
Не обязательно.
You don't have to.
Сразу какие-то завоевывать города.
Conquer cities right away.
Просто нужно начинать с малого.
All you have to do is start with a little.
То, что вы можете сегодня.
The things you can do today.
Оно может быть незначительным.
It might be so insignificant.
Но если это Божье.
But if it is God's.
Оно имеет огромную силу.
It has a huge power.
Горчичное зерно.
The mustard seed.
Оно самое маленькое.
It is the smallest of the seeds.
Но Иисус сказал.
But Jesus said.
Что вот это зерно.
That this seed.
Оно имеет такую силу.
Has tremendous power.
Что становится таким великим.
That it becomes this huge tree.
Большим деревом.
Huge tree.
Где птицы укрываются.
Where the birds find shelter.
Я хочу, чтобы вы поняли.
I want you to understand.
Малое Божье.
That the smallest thing that
имеете,
might belong to God and you have.
Оно намного сильнее.
It is a lot greater.
Оно намного превосходит.
It is a lot more exalted.
Всего сильного этого
than
мира.
Than all the power of this world.
Мы даже не подозреваем.
We don't even recognize.
Чем мы обладаем.
What we already obtain.
Если даже это как горчичное зерно.
And even if it's as small as a mustard seed.
Это достаточно.
That is plenty.
Чтобы повлиять на этот.
It's enough to influence this world.
Чтобы быть солью.
For us to be the salt.
Я помню, когда я неоднократно уже рассказывал.
I remember, and I've shared this multiple times already.
Я помню, мы много лет назад.
But I remember many years ago.
Если кто-то был в Хонолулу.
We were in Hawaii. If somebody went to Honolulu.
Там есть центральная такая улица.
There's a
возле океана.
One of the boardwalks near the coast. Walking down Waikiki, and people have different shows there. There's different musicians performing. Actors come out there. And so we came in at night. We were walking around, and we heard beautiful singing.
Там не было музыки, просто кто-то поёт.
It was just an a cappella.
Мы увидели, что много людей стояло.
And we saw a crowd of people standing around. We came up.
То мы увидели, это был детский хор.
And we saw a children's choir.
Дети примерно от 7 лет
Children
до 12.
From about 7 to 12 years old.
Мальчики и девочки.
Boys and girls.
Мы не знаем, с какой это церкви.
We don't know what church they were from.
Но их было примерно,
but there was about
60 человек.
60 kids.
Они стояли и так красиво пели, восхваляли Бога.
And they stood and sang so beautifully and praised God.
И стояло столько много людей.
And there was a crowd of people gathered.
Их фотографировали.
They were taking pictures.
Люди просто аплодировали,
people
когда они
were clapping when they finished.
И начинали другую.
And they, when they would start the next song.
Это были гавайские дети.
These were Hawaiian children.
И мы также вместе со всеми наслаждались этим.
And singing. So we stood with the crowd and we enjoyed the singing.
И одна девочка,
and a little
лет
girl,
8,
about 8 years old,
она абсолютно не была ничем, что могло привлекать к ней.
She didn't stand out in any way that could have attracted somebody to her.
Ее подняли.
But they raised her up
на какую-то просто платформу.
Onto some platform.
И она посмотрела на всех.
And she looked at everyone.
И она стала говорить.
And she started saying,
люди,
people,
вы приехали сюда.
You've come here.
У вас разные цели.
You have different goals.
Восьмилетняя девочка.
An 8-year-old girl.
И стала говорить такие слова.
And she started saying these words.
Может быть, кто-то оставил свою жену,
Maybe
чтобы приехать здесь
left
найти
their wife to come and
себе какую-то женщину.
A woman for themselves here.
Кто-то, может быть, еще по каким-то целям.
Maybe somebody else came for some other goals.
Кто-то приехал, чтобы пить здесь
somebody
алкоголь.
Came to drink alcohol here.
Проводить как хочет время.
To spend this time the way
Я
he wants.
Хочу вам сказать,
But I want to tell you.
Это время последнее.
This is the last time.
И Бог стучится в ваше сердце.
And God is knocking in your heart.
Где бы вы ни находились.
No matter where you're at.
Бог любит вас.
God loves you.
Поэтому Он говорит через
That's why He's speaking through my mouth. Repent tonight.
Вы знаете, Дрожь стала проходить по телу.
You know, I started experiencing a tremor in the body. This girl was filled with the Holy Spirit.
Это не было просто игра.
This wasn't just a joke or a play. And people felt it all around.
Я видел, как один полный мужчина.
I saw how a pretty large guy standing in the shorts.
Вначале он смеялся.
First he was laughing, taking pictures when the kids were singing.
Но во время, когда стала говорить,
but when the girl started speaking,
примерно 8 лет,
this 8-year-old girl,
вдруг он весь задрожал.
All of a sudden, he started trembling. He started crying. Tears started falling down his face. He fell on that dirty asphalt. He started screaming, God, forgive me. I'm a sinner. You know, people started crying in the crowd. Some people fell on their knees. A small girl, filled with the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit was using her right there on the island where people came to do sinful things to stop them and bring them to repentance. God is able to do a lot more than what we think of or what we can imagine. God doesn't matter to God how old you are. All He needs is your heart for it to be committed to Him. And then it doesn't matter what circumstances you're in, you can be the salt of the world. You can stop the decay. If some of you will say, there where I go to school, it's impossible. I want to tell you, with God, all things are possible. Even where you go to school, everything is possible with God for the decay to stop. You are called to influence this society. You influence your friends. Influence your peers. You're called to influence. There is a power that no one else can obtain besides those that were born from above. This is the power of the Holy Spirit. This is what we have. And we cannot hide somewhere. We cannot push this down and then say, we're just like everyone else. Dear youth, we're not like everyone else. We are people of a special calling. We are chosen by God Himself. God has determined us for His kingdom to be spread on this earth. Not the kingdom of heaven, but His kingdom. And it doesn't matter how the devil tries to demonstrate the decay. It doesn't matter how much he's saying. That's it. Everything's over. And he's trying to show you how many people have fallen. You know that this year, one pastor shared, when he was invited, once a year the president has a breakfast, a prayer breakfast. And this happens every year. And now for decades already. This happens in America. And so he came to this prayer breakfast. 5,000 pastors gathered. This was in Washington, D.C. So they welcomed them. And when they came into the hall, where the tables were set, the candles were lit, there was a lot of flowers, there was this atmosphere, they were welcomed with a smile and said, when you say something, be tolerable, be careful. We love God also, but be careful. There's a different public here. You're Christians. You gotta love everyone. You have to respect everyone. Be patient towards everyone. He said, I was shocked. I knew many influential pastors that would walk out and they spoke about everything so abstract. Nobody spoke about sin. Nobody spoke about the decay of the country. Nobody spoke about the negatives. But everyone just said that we will pray for the country to prosper. We will pray for what we have today, for us to have a better life. You know, one person, he was very young there. One of the young pastors. He was from Tennessee. I don't remember the city.
У него небольшая церковь.
He didn't have a large church.
Только начал служение.
He just started his ministry.
И он был приглашен одним пастором.
And he was invited by a pastor.
И он просто сидел там скромно.
And he was just sitting there.
И он говорил тому пастору.
And he said to the pastor,
слушай, нужно молиться.
Hey, we gotta pray.
Чтобы разложение остановилось.
For the decay to stop.
Законы принимаются.
For the laws that are being passed.
И этот пастор, который его пригласил.
And the pastor that invited him.
Который уже в возрасте.
That was already older.
Он его брал за руку.
He took him by the hand.
И говорил ему, сынок.
He said, son.
Только не здесь.
Just not here.
Здесь тебя не поймут.
Nobody's gonna understand
Только не
you here.
Здесь.
Just not here.
Вы знаете, все друг друга поздравляют.
And everyone was congratulating
Вышел
one another.
Вышел президент.
The president came
который
out.
Который сказал несколько минут
who
о том,
spoke for a few minutes
какие все пастыря хорошие.
About how wonderful
Я
all the pastors are. That I rely on you.
Мы можем что-то много
We
сделать.
We can do a lot together.
И все аплодировали.
And everybody was applauding him.
Несколько минут стоя стояли.
They were standing clapping to the president.
И он, и этот молодой человек.
And this young man.
Этот молодой пастор,
this young pastor,
он сидел утомился.
He sat there and just was in pain.
Он говорит, я просто обратил внимание,
I just noticed
что имя президента,
that the name of the president
упоминалось буквально через
was mentioned literally every other second.
Но имя Иисуса,
but the name of Jesus
всего дважды было сказано,
was mentioned only twice
за всю эту,
the entire prayer breakfast.
Возлюбленные,
Beloved,
кто-то сегодня должен подняться.
Somebody's got to stand up today.
Кто-то сегодня должен заявить.
Somebody's got to proclaim
о том, в кого он верит.
The who he believes.
Вы то поколение.
You are that generation that's got to do that.
Вы должны остановить.
You have to stop the decay.
Вы должны подняться.
You have to stand up.
Вы должны громко сказать.
You have to proclaim loudly who you believe in.
Кто ваш господин?
Who is your Lord?
Кто ваш господин?
Who is your master?
Сегодня, если не мы,
Today, if it's not us,
если не ты и
if
не
it's
я,
not you and I,
то кто тогда?
Then who will do it?
Вы знаете, Богу не нужны тысячи.
God doesn't need thousands.
Ему нужен ты.
God needs you.
Он сегодня смотрит,
God looks today,
когда стена разрушена,
when the wall is broken,
когда бедствие приходит через разрушение в этот город,
when the decay is coming through the destruction
стена
to this
это,
world.
Это защита.
The wall is the
Всегда,
protection.
Когда строился город,
when a city was built,
Вокруг него
they would build
строилась стена.
A wall around it.
Это была защита.
And that was always considered as protection.
Но вот были города,
But there were cities
где разрушали эти стены,
where the walls were destroyed.
И тогда захватывали этот город.
And the city was captured.
И тогда разрушали
And
его.
They would destroy the city.
Людей грабили.
They would bury the people.
И однажды Бог сказал,
And God said
Он сказал пророку,
He said to a prophet
что стена разрушена.
That the wall is broken.
Я ищу человека.
And I'm seeking a person
кто может встать в
who could stand in the gap,
кто встанет в этот
пролом, who will stand in that broken wall,
грабеж,
where the burglary is happening,
убивают,
where people are being killed,
встать,
who can stand in the gap.
Сказал,
and the prophet said,
вот я, Господь,
Here I am.
Возьми меня.
Send me.
Пошли меня.
Send me.
Ему нужен человек.
He needs a person.
Он не ищет тысячи.
He's not seeking for
Он
thousands.
Ищет тебя.
He's seeking for
Одного
you.
Человека,
One person
который может сказать,
that will say,
вот я,
Here I am, Lord.
Мне все равно, как
I don't care
подумают.
What people
Мне
think about me.
Буду я популярен
I don't care
нет.
If I'm popular or not.
Буду я жить в позоре
I don't care
нет.
If I'm going to live in humiliation
Но мне
or not.
Равно, Господь,
But what I do care about
говоришь.
Is that what
я
you're speaking. I want to be obedient
я
to you. I want to stand in this position to be faithful to you.
Как только мы определяемся, его сила начинает действовать. Он начинает влиять через нас. И мы тогда видим эти чудеса. Как это поколение, ваше поколение, молодых людей, которые сегодня борются с трудностями, которые сегодня борются с похотью, сегодня
Today, at 10, at 11, 12 years, people are suffering with these sins. Teenagers today, they don't know how to live in victory today. Somebody's got to rise up in this generation and say, I know who can help you. It is the one who once helped me. If he's helped me, if he's done it for me, he will help you also. He will free you. He will give you victory. He will walk you through. He will make you a person, a faith, a person who will reach the goal. Dear people,
Бог продолжает смотреть
God
сегодня.
Continues to look today.
Он сегодня смотрит на тебя.
He's looking at you.
Он, возможно, обращаясь, когда смотрит на тебя,
When he's looking at you,
и говорит,
he says,
Алексей,
Алексей,
Вика,
Вика,
Мария,
Мария,
Кристина,
Кристина,
Алена,
Алена,
Виктор,
Виктор.
Я хочу, чтобы ты встал в проломе.
I want you to stand in the gap.
Когда сегодня в этих школах разложения.
When there's decay in these
когда
schools.
Когда ты идешь по этим улицам.
When you're walking down these streets, you see the decay.
Моральные ценности падают.
The moral values falling in our eyes.
Тысячи людей сегодня сдались.
Thousands of people have given up.
Опустили руки.
They've let their hands fall.
Мы ничего не можем сделать.
And said we can't do anything.
Бог смотрит на нас.
God's looking at us.
Я рассчитываю на тебя.
Says I rely on you.
Если ты поверишь.
If you will believe.
Ты все сможешь.
You will do.
Разложение будет остановлено.
The decay will be stopped.
И еще сотни.
And hundreds.
И тысячи людей.
And thousands of people. Will come into my kingdom. Thanks to you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
В завершение я хочу рассказать вам случай один.
I want to tell you one instance.
Многие из вас знают.
Many of you know about this.
Но я бы хотел напомнить об
этом. But I want to remind you about this.
Потому что есть в жизни такие моменты,
because we have moments in our life,
которые вдохновляют
нас, that encourage us to do more.
Я помню, мы несколько лет назад
I remember a few years ago,
ездили в Москву, проводили
we went to Moscow
encounter.
And we did an encounter service there.
Когда мы туда ехали,
when we went there,
я хотел встретиться с одной девочкой,
I wanted to meet with a girl,
о которой я узнал от своей жены,
of whom I found out through my wife,
она инвалид,
that she's a handicap.
Это подруга ее детства.
This was a friend of
даже
her childhood.
Сказать, не подруга.
Not even a friend.
Потому что, когда моя жена была подростком,
but when my wife was a teenager,
в то время этой девочке было 5 лет.
The girl was only 5 years old at the time.
В пятилетнем возрасте у нее умер папа.
At the age of 5, her dad passed away.
И ее мама работала.
And her mom worked.
И она не знала, куда ее, с кем ее оставить.
And she didn't know who to leave her with.
И она приводила в дом моей тещи.
And so she would bring this girl over to my mother-in-law's house. And so this girl grew up with my wife.
Когда мы уже жили в Америке,
when we were already in the States,
мы получили письмо из России.
We received a letter from Russia.
Потому что, в то время,
because at that time,
когда мы жили в Грузии,
when we lived in Georgia,
семья жила там.
This family lived there.
Но потом они переехали в Центральную
but then
Россию.
They moved into Central Russia.
Когда мы получили письмо,
when we received the letter,
в этом письме
in the letter, her
она
mom,
обращалась с просьбой.
She was asking
она
a
говорила,
request.
Моя дочь
she was saying that my daughter became a handicap.
Она перенесла множество операций.
She went through multiple surgeries.
Чтобы поставить ее на ноги.
For her to stand up
нам
on her feet.
Нужны еще средства.
We need more resources.
Если вы можете помочь.
If you can help, please help us.
И мы отправляли туда
and so we would send money to them.
Чтобы как-то чем-то помочь.
To help in some way.
И когда я был в Москве,
and when I went to Moscow, I remembered her.
Мы созвонились с ней.
We called each other.
И я сказал, что я буду в Москве.
I said, I'll be in Moscow.
Если ты приедешь туда,
if you will come there,
я бы хотел с тобой встретиться.
I'd like to meet you.
Эту девочку звали Нателла.
Her name was Nutella.
Она говорит, я не смогу приехать.
She said, I won't be able to come.
Потому что мне нужна посторонняя помощь.
Because I need help.
Я не могу сама передвигаться.
I can't move myself.
Я практически от пояса до пяток, я парализован.
Pretty much waist down, I'm paralyzed.
Я говорю, какой ближайший город?
I said, what's the closest city?
Куда ты можешь
that
приехать?
You can come to.
Она говорит, Волгоград.
She said, I can come to Volgograd.
Под Волгоградом у меня живет брат.
I have a brother who lives on,
говорю,
by Volgograd.
I
said, all right, we're going to come there.
Я помню, мы с пастором Леонидом
I remember
Писарчук
with
приехали.
Pastor Leo Писарчук, we came there.
Это девочка, которая, с которой мы встретились.
This was a girl who we met.
Она приехала с подругой.
She came with her friend.
Она зашла, когда в холл.
When she walked into the hallway.
Она не могла самостоятельно передвигаться.
She couldn't move.
На ее руках были одеты специальные такие подпорки.
Her arms had these supports.
Она упиралась
connected.
В пол.
And she would put
и потом
the supports
она
down.
Все свое тело.
And then she would move her whole
она
body.
Просто тащила
she
за собой.
Would just drag
таким
it after
образом
her.
Она передвигалась.
And that's how she would move.
На следующий день
the next day,
мы встретились с ней.
We met with her.
И она расспрашивала
and
за мою жену.
About my wife,
расспрашивала за Америку.
Asked about America.
И потом я решил ей рассказать о Господе.
I decided to tell
моя
about
цель
God.
Была
my goal
приезда туда
for coming there
только лишь для того,
was one thing
чтобы рассказать ей
to
о
tell her about salvation, about Jesus Christ.
Я стал ей говорить о том,
I started telling her
что мы верим в Бога.
That we believe in God.
И я приехал, чтобы
and
тебе
I came
рассказать
to tell her about God.
Тем более я так надеялся,
and I was just hoping
что она в таком состоянии,
that a person in that situation
она так быстро откроется.
She would just open up.
И вдруг она меня останавливает.
And all of a sudden she stops me.
Она говорит мне.
And she says,
если вы хоть немножко
if you, in the,
имеете уважение ко мне,
in the least bit respect me,
я прошу вас,
I ask you,
ничего
don't tell
не говорите мне о Боге.
Anything about God.
Для меня, я впервые вообще это услышал.
Honestly, I heard that for the first time.
Была хорошая обстановка.
We had a good atmosphere.
И вдруг она говорит,
and all of a sudden she tells me, tell me nothing.
Я немножко посидел, потом говорю, я могу знать причину.
Can I ask the
reason
why?
Почему ты, Нателла, не хочешь слушать о Боге?
Why you don't want to hear about God?
Она говорит, я в принципе не верю.
She said, pretty much I don't believe in it.
Мне так легче жить.
It's easier for me to live this way.
Но если он есть,
but if he exists,
это самый жестокий Бог,
this is the most cruel God,
о котором я не хочу слышать.
And I don't want to hear about him.
И она рассказала мне историю.
And she told me the story.
Она говорит, я родилась в Грузии.
She said, I was born in Georgia.
Меня мама воспитывала.
My mom raised me.
В кавказских принципах.
With high moral standards.
Я никогда не курила.
I never smoked.
Никогда не пробовала вина.
Never tried, never tasted wine.
Когда я поступила в университет.
When I went to a university.
В Центральной России.
In Central Russia.
То за ней стал ухаживать молодой парень.
A young guy started dating her.
Он тоже учился там.
He was also studying there.
И она ему сказала.
And she told him.
Если у тебя серьезные намерения.
If you have serious intentions towards
то
me.
То знай.
Then know this.
У нас не будет сексуальных отношений.
We're not going to have a sexual relationship outside of marriage.
Через время он ей сказал.
He told her in a little bit.
Я никогда до этого не встречал такой девушки.
I've never met a girl like you before.
Чтобы была чистая.
For her to be pure.
Он говорит, я тебе еще больше за это.
He said, I love you even more because of that.
Мы будем ждать, когда закончим.
We're gonna wait for us to finish the university.
И я потом женюсь на тебе.
And I'm gonna marry you.
Через время его переправили на в другой университет.
In a little while, he got moved to another university in Moscow.
Но разговор стал ходить по университету.
But the rumor spread in their university.
О том, что Нателла.
That Нателла.
Уже в свои
she was already 18, but that she's never had any sexual relationships. And the guys were drinking somewhere.
They
said, that's impossible. In our day, for a girl
to
be a virgin, that's impossible. And so they made a bet. And so with a lie, they convinced her to get into their car. They brought her to an apartment. They said, hey, your boyfriend told us. He wants to do a surprise for you. He's actually waiting for you in that apartment. And they got up to the sixth floor. And when they walked into the house, they locked the door behind them. And they told her, you're not going to walk out of here. We made a bet about you. Either willfully, you have to allow us to sleep with you, or we're going to rape you. We're going to give you a few minutes to decide. And they went into the kitchen to drink. She said, I stood in that room.
И говорит, я обратилась к Богу.
And I turned to God.
Я стала говорить, Боже,
and I started saying, God,
если ты есть,
if you exist,
сделай что-нибудь.
Do something about this.
Вытащи меня оттуда.
Take me out of here.
Не позволь, чтобы они издевались надо мной.
Don't let them torture me.
И говорит, прошло несколько минут.
And a few minutes passed.
Ничего не изменилось.
Nothing was changing.
Они зашли пьяные.
They came in drunk.
И говорит, я видела по их глазам.
And I saw in their eyes
что они намерены сделать.
That they were intending to do it.
Я, говорит, посмотрела, было открыто окно.
And I saw an open window.
Я выскочила.
And I jumped out.
На балкон.
I jumped out to the balcony. And I jumped off the sixth floor.
Я, говорит, в этот момент.
And at that moment,
приняла решение.
I made the decision.
Покончить жизнь самоубийством.
I'd rather commit suicide.
Нежели позволить, чтобы
than
они
to allow them to do that to me.
Она говорит, к моему удивлению.
She said, to my surprise.
Я, говорит, не умерла.
I didn't die.
Хотя она упала и попала в канализационную.
She fell and actually landed in a sewer system.
Рабочий один человек.
And very early in the morning, one person was going to work. He saw her. He called the ambulance. They took her to the hospital.
Она 16 дней не приходила.
She didn't come to her consciousness for 16 days. The doctors just expected her to die.
Кости ее ног, они разбили таз и вошли во
The bones broke her hips and went into her torso.
В трех местах был переломан позвоночник.
She had three broken spine.
Они
she had a trauma in the skull.
Несовместимо.
They said that this just can't be fixed. You can't fix this person. This person
Но
can't
говорит,
live.
На 16-е сутки.
But 16 days
я
later,
пришла в себя.
She came to.
И я, говорит, еще больше в этот момент.
And at that moment, even more,
возненавидел
I hated God.
Как он так мог сделать?
How could he allow this?
Когда я узнала, что я буду парализованный,
that I'm going to be paralyzed for the rest
для
of
меня
my life.
Жизнь закончилась в эти 18 лет.
Life ended for me right there and then.
И она говорит, и ты говоришь, что есть
and
Бог.
You're telling me that there's a God?
За что такое наказание?
Why would he punish me like this?
У меня была правильная жизнь.
I had the right way of life.
Я хранила себя.
I kept myself pure.
Я держала себя в чистоте.
I kept myself clean.
У меня были лучшие планы.
I had good intentions for my future.
Я хотела закончить.
I wanted to finish the university.
Я хотела работать по своей
I wanted to work in my profession.
Но что сейчас?
But now what?
Я инвалид.
I'm a handicap.
Я никому не нужна.
Nobody needs me.
Этих пацанов их посадили.
And these young guys, they went to jail.
Но из-за того, что их родители были влиятельны.
But because their parents were influential in the city,
они отсидели маленькие
They sat for very short times.
Они она говорит, их выпустили,
and they're released,
на свободе.
And they're free.
Я говорит, ненавижу этих
She said, I hate these people.
Они испортили мою
They ruined my life.
Если было у меня такое право,
If I had the right,
я бы разорвала их на куски.
I would tear them up into pieces with my bare hands.
Вы знаете, передо мной сидела эта девушка.
You know, this young girl sat in front of me.
Она была зажатая, как пружина.
She was tense like a spring.
У меня не было слов.
I had no words to answer to her.
Она не хотела слушать больше
о Боге. She didn't want to hear about God.
У нее были существенные аргументы.
She had very substantive arguments.
Единственное, что я сидел и думал.
The only thing I experienced was I was thinking.
Господи,
Lord,
у меня нету слов.
I don't have any words.
Я не знаю, что сказать.
I don't know what to say to her.
Но позволь мне что-то сделать.
But let me do something.
Я обратился к ней и сказал, Нателла.
And I turned to her and I said, Nutella,
могу я тебя обнять?
Can I hug you?
Она говорит, да, пожалуйста.
She said, please.
Я сел рядом с ней на диван.
I sat next to her on the couch.
Я прижал к себе эту девушку.
I hugged this girl.
Такое впечатление, что я взял кусок металла.
It felt like I took a piece of
Она
steel.
Была в таком напряжении.
She was so tense.
И я просто ее крепко обнял.
And just firmly I hugged her.
И внутренне я продолжал молиться.
And inside I continued to pray.
Святой Дух,
I said, Holy Spirit,
только ты силен.
Only you are able.
Растопить эту,
to melt
эту ледяную гору в ее
melt
сердце.
This ice-cold mountain in her heart.
Пусть твоя любовь
Let your love penetrate her heart.
Я ничего не говорил.
I didn't say anything.
Я только внутренне молился.
I was just praying inside.
И молился на иных
языках. And praying in tongues.
И она стала плакать.
And she started crying.
Я не встречал, чтобы люди так плакали.
Never seen a person cry like that.
Это был такой вопль.
This was such a violent
Слезы
cry.
Настолько сильно,
Tears are flowing
что свитер, который
so much that the sweater that I had on
он был полностью мокрый
was completely soaked from her tears.
Диван, на котором мы
the
сидели,
couch we sat on
он начал подпрыгивать
it started jumping and shaking from her cries.
И потом она так вот обмякла.
And then she just grew soft.
И подняла голову.
And lifted up her head.
И я посмотрел ей в глаза.
I looked her in the eyes.
Это были другие глаза.
And these were different eyes.
Там не было злости.
There was no anger.
Она смотрела и говорит.
She looked and said.
Удивительное чувство.
I've never felt this before.
Я переживаю сейчас.
It's so interesting.
Во мне нету ненависти.
I don't have any hatred.
Я могу простить этим
людям. I can forgive these guys.
Я был удивлен.
I was shocked.
Я ей говорю, Нателла, это
I said,
надо
Nutella,
сделать.
You have to do this.
И мы стали там с ней в молитве.
And we started praying.
Она открыла свое сердце.
She opened her heart.
Она своими устами провозгласила.
With her mouth she proclaimed.
Иисус, ты мой Господь.
Jesus, you are my Lord.
Я принимаю тебя в
свое сердце. I accept you into my heart.
Я хочу служить тебе.
I want to serve you.
Возьми меня.
Take me.
Несколько минут.
A few minutes.
Этот человек.
In a few minutes, this
был
person
ожесточен.
Just a few minutes ago, she was so angered at life, hated her destiny, everyone around her. And within just a few minutes, this was a completely different person. I can't just remember this without emotions. The next day, we said goodbye to her. I'd like to show how she looks today. This is Nutella that I'm talking about.
The next day,
we said goodbye, she left.
Мы даже не знали, есть ли в том городе церковь.
We didn't even know if there was a church in her city.
Через время она сообщила.
In a little bit, she let us know that she found a church.
Говорит, похоже, они верят так, как и вы.
She said, it looks like they believe the way you do. I said, what do you mean?
Я говорит, ходила по многоэтажным домам.
She said, I walked
around
homes and I asked people.
Вы не знаете таких верующих?
Do you know Christians?
Которые говорят аллилуйя.
That say hallelujah.
And
they said, no, we don't know. She'd go to another house.
Do
you know about Christians that say hallelujah? Yeah, there are some people that live right here. She went into that house. And these were our Christians. They brought her to a church.
And
for the first time, she came to a church.
In
a little bit,
she
went to study at a Bible school. Then she went to
Kyiv.
In Kyiv, she studied in a... also in another Bible school. And then with Roman
Krychuk,
we were invited to Ukraine. And I called her up. She was happy. She said, what hotel are you staying at? I let her know, gave her the address. We're sitting in the hall. The door's open. And enters a young lady. I was imagining her to come once again, barely. But she was standing upright. She just had a small little walking stick that she leaned on. But she was walking straight. We were shocked. I said, Nutella, what happened to you? She said, the Lord healed me. All I have is one leg, just a little shorter than the other. It's for people to just believe that once I experienced 37 surgeries.
That
I didn't have a single bone that wasn't broken in my body. My nerves are broken on my spine. Today I can feel my body. I can walk. We spent a full day with her. I said, what do you do? She says, I have a simple ministry. I don't preach. But I move in with students, girls, in an apartment where 5-6 girls live at a time. And I just move in with them. In 2-3 months later, all these girls become Christian. That's my ministry. She said, over 2 years already, I've changed many apartments already. And in each one of these apartments, these students, they come to God. And she was showing many pictures. This is a simple girl out of Central Russia that once allowed the Holy Spirit to touch her heart, her broken heart, where she received healing from these injuries of the soul. And today she serves people just like her. She goes into hospitals. She ministers to people who are handicapped, people who are on the verge of suicide. And she tells them that there is hope. The one who dragged me out of this darkness, he's able to drag you out as well. And you know, tens and tens of people, and today already hundreds, through this fragile girl, have come into the kingdom of God. I want to show another picture. Because she got married a few years ago. This is her husband.
С этим человеком они уже открывают в этом году
this year,
пятый реп-центр.
They're opening the fifth rehab center together.
Вы знаете, сотни людей через этот центр.
Are going
Она
through these
никогда
rehab
не употребляла наркотики.
She's never used drugs.
Никогда не курила.
She's never
никогда
smoked.
Не пила.
She's never drank.
Сегодня служит этим
And today
людям,
she serves these people,
которые оказались закованы цепями
who are chained down with the chains of the devil.
Вы знаете, нам кажется, что мы должны быть великими,
we think that we have to be great,
чтобы на кого-то повлиять.
To influence anybody.
Нет.
No.
Нужно просто знать свое
We just have to know our foundation.
Любить Иисуса.
We must love Jesus.
Быть верным Ему.
We must be faithful to
Him. Позволить Ему использовать нас.
And allow Him to use us.
И тогда мы увидим, как этот мир вокруг нас
how this world around
начнет меняться.
Will start to change.
И мы увидим этих людей,
and we will see these people,
не потерянных в этом мире,
not lost in this
а приобретенными
world, but acquired for God's kingdom.
Все возможно,
Everything is possible if we believe.
Давайте мы
Let us stand up.
Я хочу призвать вас.
I want to call you, beloved.
Ваш возраст.
In your age.
На него сделана большая ставка.
There's a huge wager on you. Because you're energetic.
У вас есть все.
You have everything you need.
Поэтому дьявол
That's why the devil
не заинтересован,
is interested,
чтобы вы были в Божьем Царстве.
Or sorry, the devil is interested to take you out of the kingdom of the
Но
of
в этот вечер
But tonight,
я хочу, чтобы вы как никогда
I want you, like never before,
сделали твердое решение,
to make a firm decision,
чтобы вы могли однажды
for you to once
сказать с миллионами других
say
людей,
with millions of other people,
людей веры,
people of faith,
включая тех,
including those,
как это Нателла,
like this Nutella,
которые отказались от другого выбора.
Who rejected another decision.
Я тоже в категории этих людей.
And I am also one of
Я
these people.
Сказать,
I want to tell you.
У меня нету выбора.
I have no choice.
У меня был один выбор.
I had one choice.
Это пойти за Иисусом.
And that is to follow Jesus.
И все другие варианты я отбросил.
All my other options I threw away.
Мне 50 лет.
I'm 50 years old.
И я ни на мгновение
не пожалел. Instant did I regret that in my life. And when I was 17 years old, I made that decision. I've never regretted it. Over this my life, I've seen a lot in my life. But God has never let me down. People have let me down. I had a lot of things happen. But God has never let me down. I don't want to make another decision to
go for this
world. To follow this world. I made a decision. I've cast off everything to follow Jesus.
Yes.
He's the only one that I'm in love with more than all. That is the only identity for which I'm willing to live. Because He is my blessing. And through Him, I am blessed. My wife is blessed. My children are blessed. Blessed are the people that I fellowship with. Because God that I believe in is a good God. I want this time that God has determined for your life for you to live for Him.
Может быть, это будет 10 лет.
Maybe this might be 10 years.
Может быть, будет 20.
Maybe 20.
У кого-то 30.
Some might have 30.
У кого-то может быть 50.
Some might have 50.
У кого-то больше.
Maybe more.
Или меньше.
Maybe less.
Но чтобы все эти годы
But for all these years,
были прожиты для него.
To be lived.
В этом смысл жизни.
For him, because that's the point of life.
Бог
when God
может повлиять на этот мир.
Can influence this world.
Используя тебя.
Using you.
Вы знаете, некоторые люди, они цепляются за жизнь.
You know, some people grab a hold of life.
Чтобы как-то продлить.
And they want to extend it.
Я понял такую вещь.
I've understood one thing.
Не важно, сколько я проживу.
It doesn't matter how many years I live.
Не надо ждать долгой жизни.
I don't need to wait for a long life.
Важно прожить полную жизнь.
It's important to live a full life.
Полную жизнь.
A full life.
Это жизнь связана с ним.
It's a life that deals with him.
Это полная жизнь.
That is the full life.
Я однажды понял.
I once understood.
Что приняв его в свою
That by accepting Him into my heart, I've accepted this eternal life. And I don't care anymore. When I will leave this earth, I am an eternal person. I live with Jesus. I started living with Him on this earth. And now I will live with Him forever. Even when I leave this earth, I will always be with Him. My heart is filled with joy that once
Он не прошел мимо меня.
He didn't pass by me.
Я мог быть потерян, как миллионы других.
I could have been lost like millions of other people.
Я мог родиться в мусульманской семье.
I could have been born in a Muslim country and never know about God.
Но Бог благоволил ко мне.
But God had favor towards
когда
me.
Когда я погибал в своих
грехах, when I was dying in my sin,
он не прошел мимо.
He didn't walk past me.
Он коснулся
he
меня.
He touched me.
Когда у меня не было надежды,
when I had no hope,
он вытащил меня
he dragged me out of there.
Омыл свою кровь.
He washed me with his blood.
Как теперь я могу?
How can I now
отвернуться от него?
Turn away from him?
Он мой Господь.
He is my Lord.
Другого Бога мне нет.
And there's no other God.
Иисус мой Господь.
Jesus is my Lord.
Я хочу то, что я сегодня вам говорю.
I want to
передать это.
What I've told you today, I want to pass this on.
В вашей жизни.
So that in your life,
был Иисус Господь.
You would have Jesus as
Иисус
Lord.
Господь.
Jesus as
не
Lord.
Не модная одежда.
Not your fashionable clothes.
Не дорогие машины.
Not your expensive cars.
Не большие деньги в банке.
Not a lot of money in your bank.
Не развлечения в этом мире.
Not entertainment in this world.
Это все ничто.
All of this is nothing.
Однажды это все будет уничтожено.
One day all of this will be destroyed. All of this will pass.
Но есть сокровище.
But there is a treasure.
Которое никогда не прекратится.
That will never end.
Это наша вера.
This is our faith.
Самую могущественную личность
in the most powerful identity in the universe.
Это вера в Иисуса.
The faith in Jesus.
Он наш Господь.
He is our Lord.
Я хочу, чтобы в вашей жизни
I want your life
Он был Господом.
For him to be the Lord.
Тогда мы достигнем цели.
Then we will reach the goal.
Тогда мы увидим тысячи спасенных
Then we will
людей.
See thousands of saved people.
Тогда мы повлияем
Then
на
we
место,
will influence this place where we live.
И тогда его имя будет прославлено.
And then his name will be glorified.
Тогда мы принесем
When we bring a lot of fruit into His kingdom.
Hallelujah. Драгоценный Иисус.
Precious Jesus.
Нам так приятно.
We are so thankful
в общении с тобой.
To be in fellowship with you.
Мы благодарны тебе.
We thank you.
За твою безмерную любовь.
For your great love.
Что ты искупил нас.
That you've redeemed us.
Что мы твои.
That we are yours.
Мы в твоих руках.
That we are in your hands.
Ты избрал нас.
You've chosen us.
Ты вырвал нас из мира.
You've ripped us out of the world.
Ты привлек нас к себе.
You've attracted us to yourself.
Чтобы мы научились от тебя.
For us to learn.
Чтобы мы жили для тебя.
For us to live for you.
Чтобы мы были похожи.
For us to be like you.
Я благодарю тебя.
I thank you.
За этих прекрасных людей.
For these wonderful people.
За этих молодых.
For these young people.